I wanted to say, inshallah, advice to myself and to all of you, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. The greatest thing that a person asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide him after Jannah and to ask Allah to protect him from the hellfire, the greatest thing after those two is to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you for your sins. مَا حُمِّلَ عَلَىٰ كَاهِنٍ شَيْءٍ عَظَمٍ مِّنْ ذَنْبٍ يَحْمِلُهُ بَنْ وَآدَمٍ. There is nothing a person carries on his shoulder with him the day of judgment greater than sins the children of Adam. They do sins, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to it as wizr. There is no one, brothers and sisters, who is able to uplift those sins from you, take it from you, wipe it out of your record. Illa khallaqul alim. The one who created you and the one who knows everything you do. Qadirun ala an yaghfirha. Allah has the ability to forgive you for those sins. I wanted to say, if the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu to say, Allahumma inni dhalamtu nafsi dhulman kathira, wa la yaghfiru dhunuba illa ant faghfir li maghfiratan min indik, warhamni innaka antal ghafurur rahim. If now our Prophet Muhammad taught Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, akhadna bi wasiyyati rasulillah, we will take the advice of the Messenger. لصديق الأمة أبي بكر الصديق, that he gave to the most trustworthy man in this ummah, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And we say the same, اللهم إنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. Oh Allah, we've sinned a lot of sins. We've done great scales of sins. If you don't forgive us, we will be from those who were destroyed and destructed. Sometimes, when something is hard to achieve in life, or something that you fear hits you, people tend to not remember Allah these times. Al-izzu al-matloob, aw tasallutu al-marhoob. The people don't remember Allah at these two moments. And here, يَظْهَرُ حَقِيقَةَ التَّعَلُّقِ بِاللَّهِ. This time it becomes clear who is the one who's holding on to Allah. Who is the one who is a true believer of Allah. فَبَعْضُ النَّاسِ إِذَا عَزَّ الْمَطْلُوبِ يَقِلُّ وَيَحْجَمُ. Some people, they find that what they're trying to achieve, it's not going to ever happen for them. Or what they wanted to stay away from, the harmful things, it's hitting them. يَحْجَمُ عَنِ الدُّعَاءِ. لماذا? Why? Why would he do that? ظَنًّا مِنْهُ أَنَّ هَذَا لَنْ يُرْفَعَ. Assuming and believing that this sin, this thing that he wants to achieve, لَنْ يَتَحَقَّقَ. It will never happen. And the thing he's running away from, this harm that's afflicted her or him, they think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can't uplift it. مَنِ الَّذِي يَقُومُ عَلَى الدُّعَاءِ. Who is the one at this time, when everyone gives up, who is the one that's going to stand and lift his hands up and ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala? مَنْ حَسُنَ ظَنُّهُ بِاللَّهِ. The person who believes good of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, this is the time. The person who trusts and has a belief in Allah, well, then doesn't matter how much he feels like he cannot achieve what he wants to achieve, and how much he thinks that this thing he's running away from, this pain that has afflicted him, cannot leave him, he will run to Allah because he has no anis. He has no one who's going to help him and support him, no ally except Allah. He knows that. حَسُنَ ظَنُّهُ بِاللَّهِ. His belief in Allah is great and is immense. Wallahi, ليس كما يفهم. It's not how you and some people understand بادي الرأي أن الله رحيم ويقف هذا. It is, sisters, you have to know حسن الظن doesn't mean that you just believe Allah is merciful and you ask Allah. Rather, it's immense and it's more greater than that. Because من حسن ظنه بالله, anybody who believes good of Allah, يعلم أن الله يقدر. أولا يعرف أن الله يقدر. The person whose thought of Allah is great, he knows that Allah has the ability. وأن الله يرحم. And that he knows Allah is merciful. With those two, يَحْسُنُ ظَنُّهُ بِاللَّهِ. If the person doesn't know that Allah is able to do things and Allah is merciful, his request and asking for Allah that wouldn't come. I give you an example today in this world that we live in. If you're afflicted with a pain and you have a problem, your parents would want to take this pain away from you, but do they have the ability to do so? No, they don't. All of it is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these are things that has to أن يستقر في قلبك. These are things that has to be affirmed in your heart. And that you know لا يقدر على نصرتك إلا لله. No one can give you victory except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا يستطيع أن يرفع بلاءك إلا الله. No one can uplift your pain and your suffering except Allah. فحسنك ظن فح فإذا حسن ظنك بالله, if your thought of Allah becomes great and it soaks in your heart, it becomes the miftah, it becomes the key to your success. Know that أنه لا يعجزه شيء. Allah, there's nothing that weakens him and tires him. That which is in the sky, في الأرض, on the earth, ولا في السماء, in the sky. The reality is, لابد أن يستقر هذا في القلب. This has to be affirmed in the heart, not something we just utter daily and day out, but it has to be affirmed in our hearts. I want you to all remember that these are not things you would learn if you go to universities, and these are not what you learn if you go to institutes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أو كالذي مر على قرية وهي خاوية على عروشها قال أن يحيي هذه الله بعد موتها فأماته الله 100 عام ثم بعث قال كم لبثت؟ قال لبثت يوما أو بعض يوم قال بل لبثت 100 عام فانظر إلى طعامك وشرابك لم يتسنى وانظر إلى حمارك ولنجعلك آية للناس وانظر إلى العظام كيف ننشزها ثم نكسوها لحما فلما تبين له قال أعلم أن الله أعلم أن الله على كل شيء قدير. هذا والله هي المفتاح العبودية. والله that's the key to servitude. الأعظم أن تعلم that you always know أن الله على كل شيء قدير. هذا إذا تيقن في قلبك ورسخت. والله if that becomes affirmed in your heart and you know it, you don't care of anyone who tries to harm you, he's harmed. Anyone who wants to afflict you with pain or whatever he wants to do, you don't care. لا تقف على باب أحد. والله you will never request and ask anyone. والله لا يوجد أحد. There is no individual. إذا غلب على ظنه بل ملأت قلبه يقينا أن الله وحده على كل شيء قدير. That a person whose heart becomes filled up with certainty and a belief that Allah alone is the one who has the ability to do so. Except that every harm that touches him and everything he wants to achieve, he'll always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, these are things you find in the Quran. Allah chose prophets. He chose creations from his servants. Those that people thought were low, and low in their statuses and their ranks. In the eyes of the people, they were nothing. Nabiullah Musa, Unzur, is a prophet of Allah. He couldn't speak properly. قال تعالى, Allah said in the Quran, أم أنا خير من هذا الذي هو مهين ولا يكاد يبين. Pharaoh is saying, this one who can't even clarify his affairs, put truth to the matters of what he has. Is he better or am I, Pharaoh, better? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose Musa alayhi salam, هو النبي من أنبياء الله تعالى. Allah جعله وكان عند الله وجيها. He was a chosen one with Allah. لأن الله كلمه. Allah spoke to him. ونجاه, Allah gave him success. وقربه, Allah brought him close. وأدناه, Allah brought him even closer. وأغاثه, Allah saved him. ووهبه, Allah gave him a wife to marry. Who did all of this for him? Who was the one that did all this for Musa عليه السلام? أهل الحي الذي لا يموت. The one that never dies is always there for you. You cry out for him, Allah will give you. وسألك عبادي عني فإني قريب. أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان. وتوكل على الحي الذي لا يموت. Don't depend on no one. Depend on Allah alone. على الحي الذي لا يموت. He will never die. He's the only one who would give you what you want. He's the one when you ask, he wants to give you even more than what you ask. He's the one that will not blame you for asking too much or embarrass you for asking too much. Like when you ask the humans, they embarrass you. They blame you. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.